This is the Mose Persico Show on CJAD 800.
Welcome back. That, of course, is Fergie, and the song is called Glamorous. Well, needless to say, this technological modern world that we live in produces change on a daily basis. Changes that come easy and changes that most of us have learned to deal with. Thanks to the social network, Facebook, Twitter, Skype, you name it, new habits have been formed. We pin our contacts on our BlackBerry, text our friends on our smartphones. Even the publishing world has also been forced to adapt. Chances are you're probably reading your favorite magazine on an iPad or Playbook these days. But thankfully, for those of us who still enjoy the feel of a newspaper or flipping the pages of a magazine, we still have that option. And for me, life is all about options. Earlier this week, a new glossy and flashy magazine was launched here in Montreal, and this one is called RSVP. Flashy, with spectacular snapshots of high society, fashion, trends, the culinary world, and of course, insights to the cool and happening riffraffs that's associated with the good life. And joining me in studio right now, I'm pleased to welcome Maya Sardouk, who's the editor-in-chief, along with Natalie Courey, who's the advertising and PR executive. Lady, well, welcome to the show, ladies.
Thank you for having us.
Okay, well, here we are, RSVP Magazine. And as I mentioned in the intro, I mean, with everything going digital these days and all that, I, for one, love newspapers and magazines. I love the feel. Yours looks impressive. Let's talk a little about the mission, because you say here that it's a society magazine reflecting the lifestyle of the sophisticated urbanite Montrealer.
Mm-hmm.
What's an urbanite Montrealer? I like that title.
Well, basically, it's the Montrealer who likes to go out, who enjoys the good restaurants. It's basically the Montrealers who are involved with high society, charity events, very generous, successful business people who give back to the community and who like to dress up and dance and enjoy themselves. So,
and overall feel good about themselves.
Yeah, it's a very active society. We have a lot of events happening, very nice productions taking place. Mm-hmm. And that's why we decided to do this publication.
Now tell us a little about the genesis of the magazine, because like we said, magazines, we love them on the racks and all that, but the genesis of this magazine launch, Natalie, a lot of years of planning? Did it take months, or was it just a question of, hey, it's time for a new magazine?
Well, I basically came on board on this project with Maya, who already had this idea in her mind that she wanted this magazine. She used to have another magazine and decided that events was what people loved. And if you went through the older magazine, the event part was the most successful. So we really believe that this was a great way to go get Montrealers to be out on the town to see what they're up to, because everyone loves to see themselves in either newspaper or magazine, and we're kind of going to get that little, you know, part of people that would love to open the magazine and see themselves dressed in the most beautiful dresses, and their makeup is all done, and they're at this fabulous event, and it just looks really nice.
That's right, because your mission is to showcase the vibrant, elegant side of Montreal and the beautiful people who make it happen. Is there a sleazy side to Montreal? I don't think so, is there? We can't really say that, do we?
Don't. Coming from you, I don't know.
Okay. And you want to present the best of urban mosaic, which comprises this unique city. Now, there's a bilingual editorial in the magazine.
The magazine
which is, very
is
important.
Fully bilingual, right. And this is really what makes RSVP unique and different, because mm-hmm. we want to showcase the real Montreal, and the real Montreal is not only Anglophones or Francophone. So there are great events taking place in all communities, and even other, like Italian, you name it. So we cannot be only in English or French. The whole magazine is fully bilingual. All the interviews we do are fully bilingual, and this is to show the real city, the way we know it, the way we live it. And that's why it was very important to us.
That's right, because after all, our city is a melting pot of cultures.
It is,
exactly.
And it's important to target the culturally aware and the well-traveled Montrealer who basically looks for a blend of luxury and inspiration in his or her daily life. What about, you mentioned that the magazine is going to do extensive coverage along the charity social circuit.
Yes.
Tell us a little about that.
Well,
Our goal is really to cover all sorts of events, whether it's charities or other events. On the charity side, of course, we covered the Daffodil Ball, which is one, you know, a great event for cancer that has been going on for as long as I could remember. We also covered the Farah Foundation event, the Masquerade event for AIDS. So, you know, we try and we try and cover as many different events for as many causes there are in the city, really, because we really believe that the whole charity side is an important side. A lot of people invest a lot of time and money and effort into making these events great and to raising the money for the people that need them.
And people feel great when they donate money to wonderful, worthy causes, but they feel spectacular when they see their mugshots in these glossy magazines.
Exactly. And it's good also for the organizers because it's an extra, it gives them leverage to their sponsors. So that's why all the committees, they're thrilled with this project. And we've been approached. I mean, the first issue just came out last week, but already the feedback has been fantastic. Mm-hmm. So there is a demand. They it's in a way a nice recognition to all the sponsors and the big the donors and everyone who's involved and worked so hard. But we also, I want to mention that we cover a lot of golf tournaments, especially the summer, a lot of boutique openings, restaurants. So it's not only charity, but it's
That's
a
right.
society.
Of course, because there's wonderful content with respects to photography, the culinary arts, fashion, and trends. Your contributors, who's writing for this magazine? Canadians, fellow Montrealers?
Yes, it's very, very local. We have a team of Montrealers. We have a lot of good people involved, like Carolina Gallo La Flèche. We have also another Carolina Jazz, who just moved in actually from Vancouver. She's been doing great on the fashion scene. Mm-hmm. Also, Natalie did some of the write-ups. It's the first issue actually has, we chose it to be the hospitality issue. Mm-hmm. So we have, we were very lucky to have people like Chuck Hughes on the front cover with Elisabeth Limenaki, Bernard Agnault, and all the rest. So the content is very professionally done.
Now, for those out there that say, you know, I'm going virtual because technology's here and I'm using my iPad and my smartphone to get all the information I need with respects to where to eat in Montreal, where I should shop, where I should go. What do you say to those people? Are you online at any point? Is that the goal? Is that the next phase of RSVP?
Our website will be, it's rsvpmagazine.ca. Mm-hmm. The whole magazine will be converted into a flipbook, online flipbook, and you can see the whole, we can read the whole magazine cover to cover, but it's always different to have a hard copy of your picture, then you can keep it at home on your coffee table, especially when it's so well done and in high quality print.
And it's a quarterly magazine, your circulation is about 10,000 copies, and where can people pick up this magazine if they want to pick it up?
Is
it
well, they can subscribe. No, the magazine is not sold. We're distributed exclusively at all these events.
Oh, I see.
So this is our reader and this is where you're going to find us, in all the gift bags and at the events.
So there you go. So if you ever attend a charity event, chances are in the tote bag,
exactly,
upon leaving, you'll get a copy of RSVP magazine.
For sure.
Well, listen, best of luck. Maya Sardouk, the editor-in-chief, and Natalie Courey, the advertising and PR executive.